that
hey folks, today we're talking about Tony Rice's Guitar Break for Hills of Roane County off of his 1977 record. It's a cool tune. It's in 3-4, so it's a waltz. It's in D, but it's also in drop D, capo 3rd fret. I thought it would be a fun one for us to look at, figure out the syncopations and all that. Now you may look behind me and notice everything's real empty. That's because we're moving. We bought a house. So please excuse some of these videos and some of these live streams where things maybe aren't as decorated as they were before, because everything's in boxes. Now, I do want to say that this video is sponsored by the community, so thank you guys. This was a transcription order from my new friend Jim. So Jim ordered this on my website. All you have to do is go to the tab store, you scroll down, and it says, don't see the tab you're looking for. And right there, you can send me an email and hey, we can work out a deal. Maybe I can do some transcription for you. And if I like the tune, maybe I'll do a video about it, like this one that I'm doing for Jim. And just like always, through Jim's kindness, this tab is going to be available for free on my website, lessonswithmarcel.com. So please check it out. Go get the free tab. There's tons of other free tabs. Like I said, you can order those custom transcriptions. We have merch. And of course, you can sign up for Skype lessons too. We now have 3 teachers, including myself, that are teaching. So we can probably get you in faster than we could have when it was just me and my lonesome. Anyway, folks, let's break this thing down. So we're going to look at a couple important technique things first, and then we'll be able to just go through the break line by line, and I'll show you all the interesting things about it. This microphone is so in the way. We'll have a better setup at the new house, I promise. So the first thing that we should probably look at is the pentatonic scale that Tony Rice is using throughout the majority of this break. Now we're in drop D, and we're also doing a D pentatonic with open strings, which means a couple funky things happen. Normally with pentatonic scales, we get 2 notes on every string, and that's your standard pentatonic box. But in this case, with drop D and with D with open strings, we end up with a couple situations where we have 3 notes on a string, and actually one situation where we have 1 note on a string. So check out the scale pattern carefully. Now we can't just look at one pentatonic position. We're going to look at another one because Tony does use another one. So the next shape that we're looking at would kind of be box 2. I'm going to leave off the low D string for this one. We're just going to look at it on our higher strings. Here we go. And that actually covers a lot of the break. That's the majority of what's going on here. But we should probably look at just one more thing, and that's the idea of these country sixth intervals. Tony uses them just very briefly, but they're really nice if you know a little bit about them. So I'm going to teach you a couple spots where you might see them. Those intervals get used in a lot of different ways, and most of the time people alternate between those 2 different notes. That kind of sound. With those couple of things out of the way, we should be able to just dive into the break. But before we do that, I want you to listen to the break again, and I want you to look for all the things that we just talked about. It's really easy to skip this step, but it doesn't help to just learn the break by rote, to just memorize it. If you understand how it works, it's going to help you so much more. So why don't you look at the break, try to understand which pentatonic shape Tony Rice is using, watch out for those country sixths, and the whole thing's going to make so much more sense to you. So please, bear with me. Just listen to the break again. Thank you.
train pulled out.
And with that out of the way, we can do our big boy breakdown. So here we go. We're starting off on the top here. Now, most bluegrass songs that are in 4-4 have this pickup phrase that lasts three beats, right? And it normally has a rest on beat one, and then for beats 2, 3, and 4, we have a little pickup. That's not what's going on here, because this is a song in 3-4, and the pickup standards are a little less solidified for a song like that. So let's look at this interesting kickoff right here. So I have a rest on beat 1 and 2. 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Now, I wrote out the strums that I think I hear Tony play after that, but you could really just strum any rhythm here. You just have to fill in a measure with some rhythm, but I'll show you what I wrote down. So 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, and 3, and. And the next measure, we have an interesting thing, an interesting rhythmic thing. So I have 1 and, then I hammer onto beat 2, and then I play this last note on beat 3. So 1 and 2, 3, 1 and 2, 3. Make sure you get that rhythm right. The next measure is easy, just a bunch of eighth notes. 1 and 2 and 3 and, no surprise. Another measure of mostly strumming. 1, 2, and 3, and. This is a lick that I like a lot for drop D. Same count, 1 and 2 and 3 and 1. This ascending line, still our pentatonic shapes, the note choice that we expect. Ooh, so nice. Right after this, we have so much syncopation. So if you're looking at the pick strokes right above the tab, you'll see that we have a bunch of upstrokes in a row. That means everything's happening on an and, as in between the beat. So starting on this new line, it sounds like this. 1 and 2 and, 1. Let's do it again. 1 and 2 and, 1 and 2 and, 3 and. It is a funny passage, and it'll take you a little bit of time to get used to, but that's the trick, right? Everything is happening off of the beat. So moving on to the next line, I have this slide, and once again, a bunch of upstrokes. Things are happening off the beat. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1. I said 4. We don't have a beat 4. This is a waltz. We're in 3-4. Let's try it again. 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2. I know it's so much counting. The easiest way is to see the phrase as a bigger picture. Lots of and off the beat. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. Now, if you don't count, you can just listen to the recording and you can get used to how the timing works. Counting is just a great shortcut, right? If you can count, it takes the guesswork out of it. So anyway, starting with this ascending phrase. That takes us on to our next line here. And starting from here, we're gonna start seeing our country sixth. Now, if I had to count this, it would sound like this. 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and 2 and 3, 1 and 2, 3. So a lot of counting. Not gonna lie to you. Now, when I play those country six, I'm actually using my middle finger. If you don't wanna use that, you can just look at the pick strokes on the page. They're all written for standard pick strokes, down on the downbeat, up on the upbeat. But if you wanna be like me, for the lower note, I'm using my pick. For the higher note, I'm using my middle finger. And I'm doing that on these double stops too. Also using my middle finger, so think about that if you want to try it. Home stretch, lots of upstrokes. And 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 2 and 3 and 1 2 and 3. It's easier to play that passage if you start barring with this finger, right? because then you're set up to strum that chord when you have to. Last line. All those eighth notes are easy to count. One and two and three and one and two and three and one, two and three and one and one. Upstrokes means and, right? One and one. That's the whole break. Now, just like always, if you need a little something extra to help practice this, you can hit the settings wheel. You can go to playback speed, and you can slow this break down so it's a little bit easier to play along to. A lot of times when I'm learning these, I slow them down to 50% or 75% speed, anything to just give me a little extra edge so I can, you know, get my fingers in the right place and understand how it goes before I try to play it along with Tony, because a lot of times that's a tall order. So here's the playthrough with the tab up ahead. It's me playing along with the recording. Go ahead, give it a shot, slow it down if you need to. It's no biggie. This would normally be the part of the video where we say goodbye, but I have a little warning to impart to you. Now, normally, I support everything that artists put out, and I still do. Go buy Tony Rice stuff. But this book, it has mistakes in it. So some of the breaks are still really valuable in here, but there are some big mistakes in here, and I wanted to warn you that this break is one of them. So when they chose to write out this break, they actually wrote it in open F, as if Tony Rice wasn't using a capo and wasn't in drop D. He was just playing F shapes. And it's incorrect. And there's a couple signs that it is, but this is not a great transcription. The other one that's really rough in this book is Manzanita. They try to write it in a wonky time signature, and it's just not really correct. Buyer beware, get this book at your own risk. I hate to say anything bad about something Tony Rice, but I just know when I bought this book, I was pretty disappointed with some of the quality, so I figured I'd warn you guys. Wow, what a Debbie Downer thing to bring up. All right, gang, hope you liked that lesson. Remember, you can always go to the website, get that free tab, lessonswithmarcells.com. There's a ton of other free Tony Rice, Billy Strings, Molly Tuttle, Trey Hensley, Jake Workman, all the players that you like. We have free transcriptions of their work. And for a lot of those artists, we even have a little blessing from them, so they appreciate what we do. We're on good terms. I'd also appreciate if you checked out any of the merch, you signed up for Skype lessons, ordered a transcription. Of course, you can become a member downstairs if you hit that join button or hit that subscribe button. Thank you all so much for watching. I really appreciate what you do. I'm going to go pack up some more boxes so I can move into my house. I'll see you all next time. When that train comes tumbling down.